This right here is the all-new TECNO Pova 5G, and it's fast. The TECNO Pova 5G is the first smartphone from TECNO to come with a 5G modem, even though we do not have 5G here in Nigeria. It's also the first from the brand to use the Mediatek Dimensity chipset. The Dimensity 900 chipset is a 6nm processor, and to give you an idea just how powerful it is, here's the Antutu score of the Samsung Galaxy A52, the Redmi Note 10 Pro, and here's the score of the TECNO Pova 5G. Now hold on, before Samsung and Redmi fans unsubscribe and dislike this video, the TECNO Pova 5G has its flaws, which I'll get to in a bit, but with 8GB of RAM that can be expanded to 11GB of RAM and UFS 3.1 fast storage, is the TECNO Pova 5G worth upgrading to? Well, let's find out. For the unboxing experience, the box of the TECNO Pova is tall, and I mean really tall. Opening it up, you will get to see the smartphone first. It comes in one color, which is Antia Black, and it looks good with this two-tone color. Check out that logo. By the way, I used to be a Manchester United fan.
Emotional, damn it!
Back to the box, it comes with a premium plastic case that fits the smartphone well. It also comes with a warranty card, headphones, SIM card ejector tool, USB Type-C cable, and an 18 watts fast charger. For the charging time, it took 2 hours 44 minutes to charge this smartphone from 0 to 100% while the smartphone was turned off. More on that to come when we get to the battery section of this video. For the build quality, the TECNO Pova 5G has a plastic grade that scratches easily, so I recommend you use the premium plastic case that it comes with. The sides are also made from plastic, and the front doesn't have Corning Gorilla Glass protection. Now moving on to the external features, the TECNO Pova 5G has a microphone at the top. On the left side, it has a dual nano SIM card and memory card tray. Moving to the bottom, it has a 3.5mm audio jack, another microphone, a USB Type-C port, and a mono speaker. Mono speaker on a gaming smartphone. On the right side is where the volume keys and the power button / fingerprint scanner are located. For the unlock speed, it's instant. This smartphone also has the face unlock feature, and it works in the dark as well. Now moving to the rear of the TECNO Pova 5G, it has three cameras, a 50 megapixel main camera, a 2 megapixel depth camera, and a QVGA camera. So essentially it has only one main camera, the two other cameras can't take pictures. It also has an LED light at the rear. Flipping the smartphone around, the TECNO Pova 5G has a 16 megapixel selfie camera and a flash LED light. Now let's talk about the display. The TECNO Pova 5G has a massive 6.9 inch IPS LCD panel with a resolution of 1080 by 2460 pixels. The display has a refresh rate of 120Hz and a touch sampling rate of 180Hz. For peak brightness, I got a reading of 319 nits. So with all the technical jargons aside, what's it like using the display on this smartphone? Well, the first thing is the display size. It's big. Some people will like it, some won't. The TECNO Pova 5G does have the one-hand feature to make things manageable. For consumer media, the display is good. It supports HDR10 and HDR HLG. The IPS LCD display on the TECNO Pova 5G isn't as contrasty as AMOLED displays, but for an IPS LCD panel, it's actually very good. Now, let's talk about performance. The TECNO Pova 5G comes with the Mediatek Dimensity 900 processor. It's a 6nm processor that delivers good performance, offers good power efficiency, and snappier application response time. For the GPU, it comes with the Mali G68. For RAM, it comes with 8GB of RAM that can be expanded to 11GB of RAM by enabling memory fusion, which uses a portion of the phone storage to increase the RAM. And for storage, it comes standard with 128GB. So how is it like gaming on the TECNO Pova 5G? For PUBG, it played the game on HD graphics and medium frame rate. I was actually expecting more since this is a gaming smartphone. The gameplay was okay, the big display did help in making the game immersive, but that mono speaker, I kept on blocking it and it didn't make me enjoy the game. For Call of Duty, it played the game on medium graphics and very high frame rate, the gameplay was fluid. Now moving on to one of the most demanding games on mobile, Genshin Impact, the TECNO Pova 5G was able to play the game on the highest graphics settings and even at 60fps, but there was a bit of lag here and there. On the lower settings though, the gameplay was smooth. As a gaming smartphone, the TECNO Pova 5G is decent, but I expected more. I expected it to play PUBG and Call of Duty at higher graphics settings and high frame rates like the Poco X3 Pro, since they are about the same price. For multitasking, well, the TECNO Pova 5G is impressive. Honestly, I ran out of applications to open. I had 3 grade A games on. The browser was open, YouTube was open, and it didn't reload any application. For the operating system, the TECNO Pova 5G is running Android 11 with iOS version 8. Will it get Android 12 update? I mean, it has the hardware requirements, but your guess is as good as mine. Now, navigating the user interface is sputter smooth thanks to the processor, RAM, and the 120Hz refresh rate. This smartphone is snappy and very responsive. For bloatware, I counted 24 bloatware on the TECNO Pova 5G. Luckily, you can uninstall some of them. And for ads, yes, you do get them, and yes, you can disable them from the notification center. Now, something I'm not really fond of is zero screen, and sometimes you find inappropriate content on there. Now, to disable this, press an empty part of the screen, tap on the desktop settings, tap on other settings, untick zero screen. Now, for the special features, the TECNO Pova 5G has the usual. It has peak proof to prevent the next person from viewing your screen. It has theft alerts that rings out when the charger or the earphones has been disconnected from the smartphone. It has smart panel for quick access to volume, apps, and tools. It has game space where you can do a lot of things to improve your gaming experience, like increasing the footstep sound to know where players are and optimizing game graphics. For the front-facing camera, the TECNO Pova 5G has a 16-megapixel camera, and the picture it captures are sharp. They are detailed. I mean, look at the skin tone. It's nice. It looks like TECNO has really improved. Portrait shots are also very sharp, as you can see, but usable. Overall, the front-facing camera on the TECNO Pova 5G is impressive. Crazy things are happening. What's up, guys? So it's a video from the front-facing camera of the TECNO Pova 5G. So right now, it's shooting in 4K 30 frames per second. Yeah, you heard right, 4K 30 frames per second from the front-facing camera. Yeah, so what do you guys think about the video and audio quality coming up from the TECNO Pova 5G? It has 2 microphones, one at the top and one at the bottom, so I'm guessing the sound quality is better, or I'm guessing the sound quality is good. So what do you guys think about the sound quality? What do you guys think about the video quality, since this smartphone front-facing camera can shoot in 4K 30 frames per second? So yeah, let me know what you think about the camera quality and the sound quality in the comment section below. Moving on to the rear camera, the 50 megapixel main camera is good. Photos look colorful, which I prefer. Portrait shots are very impressive as well using the 50 megapixel main camera. Honestly, it looks like TECNO has stepped up their game in the camera department. Overall, the camera on this smartphone is good. For videos, the TECNO Pova 5G can shoot in 4K 30 frames per second. The first thing you will notice is at 4K 30 frames per second, it doesn't have video stabilization. For that, you will need to hit the ultra steady mode, and that will drop the video resolution to 1080p 30 frames per second. For videos captured, well, it's colorful, which I prefer, and overall, it's not bad. The TECNO Pova 5G is packing a massive 6000 mAh battery, and good luck trying to kill that battery in one day. For the charging time, it took this smartphone 2 hours 44 minutes to charge from 0 to 100% while the smartphone was turned off. Now, I will be doing a battery drain test, so subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss out on that video. And now for the price, the TECNO Pova 5G goes for 147,000 Naira or $257. For day-to-day tags, opening applications, switching between applications, this smartphone just flies. The build quality is good on this smartphone. The display is big and clear. Remember, it has an IPS LCD display, and it won't be as colorful as AMOLED displays. Gaming on this smartphone is alright. It isn't a gamer smartphone. I will be comparing it with the ultimate budget gaming smartphone, the Poco X3 Pro. So subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss out on that video. And lastly, the camera and battery life are decent on the TECNO Pova 5G. So, we've come to the end of this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys soon. Valo, signing out.